In this English lesson, I wanted to help you learn the English phrase to not give someone the time of day. If you don't give someone the time of day, it means that you are ignoring them. On a simple level, it means if they asked you what time it was, you would not tell them the time because maybe you're annoyed with them. But we use this phrase all of the time to refer to when one person does not want to talk to another person, they don't want to talk to them on the phone, and they don't want to see them. Often this can happen after two people date for a while. So maybe they are involved romantically and they go out on a few dates and then they break up. Sometimes one person doesn't even want to give the other person the time of day after that because maybe the breakup didn't go well. Maybe there are hard feelings between the two people. And so one person maybe wants to just ignore the other person and they don't want to give them the time of day. The other phrase I wanted to teach you today is the phrase, call it a day. It's late here on a Monday. You can see that there's a long shadow behind me, and I think after this video, I'm gonna call it a day. In English, when you say that you are going to call it a day, it means that you're going to stop working. It means that you're done all the work for the day, and it's time to just have a good meal and relax. So I'm sitting here at the end of a long day thinking, I think after this video, I'm gonna call it a day. Again, when you say that you're going to call it a day, it simply means that you're going to end your day of work and begin your day of relaxing or just enjoying yourself. So after this video, of course, I'm going to call it a day. I'm going to have supper. I think I'm going to just relax after supper and watch the news. I'm definitely going to call it a day as soon as I hit the stop button on this camera. Let's look at a comment from a previous video. This comment is from... I'm not sure how to say your name, but Google Translate said your name was here, or in French we say ici. So from here is this comment. Maybe you shouldn't give those annoying people the time of day. Never let anyone else get you down. And my response was, that's true. Sometimes when people say annoying things, it's best to just ignore them. So you'll notice that in this comment, the viewer used the phrase, don't give them the time of day. Let me read it again. Maybe you should not give those annoying people the time of day. Never let anyone else get you down. I think this is great advice. It's difficult to do sometimes, but I think it's important in life to not always listen to people who are negative. I know sometimes it's hard. Sometimes people have opinions about what you are doing and it's hard to not listen to them. I like the fact that the vast majority of the comments on my videos on both of my YouTube channels are positive. I actually really like reading the comments on my videos. They are overwhelmingly nice. You are all very, very nice people. And so I love reading them. But every once in a while, there will be a comment that's a little bit negative. And so what I usually think then is, this person isn't really being negative. Maybe they're just not sure how to write a really kind English sentence. Because they're learning English, maybe they are just having a little bit of trouble. So I usually give people the benefit of the doubt. In English, when you give someone the benefit of the doubt, it means they do something that may appear rude or mean. But you're thinking to yourself, well, maybe there's another reason why they said this way or wrote this way. So that's what I do with comments all the time. I think, oh, this comment seems a little bit mean, but I'll give them the benefit of the doubt because I know they're learning English. Maybe they didn't know exactly how to say this politely. Anyways, this was a great video. Thanks for watching again. I'm gonna call it a day now. I'll see you in a couple days with another new English lesson.